Alrighty, everybody, welcome back to Mike Stogie's. I hope everyone's having a great Friday. So today for you, I'm going to do a little something different that I haven't done in a little while. I'm going to do a first impressions, and I'm going to zoom in here for you like I do, because I don't want to get my lazy ass up. And today for you, we have the Arson. Now, I don't know how many of you heard about this cigar. I personally, zooming in and out, you're probably freaking out. I got this. I got the Wolfman from a cigar source on Twitter. That's who I usually get my Halloween stuff from for Tatuaje. And he included this in the package. And I've never heard of it. And I'm looking online. I'm not seeing too many reviews on it. So I figure, you know what? What the hell? I might as well get one up. So I'm gonna switch back and forth from screens to give you the information because I'm reading off. But this is and again, I'm gonna butcher it. So whatever. This cigar here is made by the industry veteran Arson Gasparian. He's launching his own line of cigars. You can find this cigar if you go to www.vitolier.net. That's V-I-T-O-L-I-E-R. Vitolier is an abbreviation for Vitola. Or if you go to www.arsencigars.com, you can find it. Over there as well. It comes in three sizes. It comes in a Toro 54x6, comes in a Robusto 50x5, and it comes in a Gordito 58x4, which is a big boy. That's what we're doing. Boxes of 25. I don't see any pricing on it, so I don't have any pricing on it. The wrappers are Dominican Republic, Habano Especial. The binders, Dominican Republic, Cubano San Vincent. And it's got a filler, Dominican Republic, Seco Habano, Vuelta Arriba, Lajero Habano, Vuelta Arriba, and Lajero Corojo. So with all that, I'm assuming this is one powerhouse of a cigar. That's what I'm assuming. But we'll see. So let's see what we get off the cigar. I'll tell you, it's constructed beautifully. It's really nice, very minimal veins, packed well, nice triple cap. I mean, really, it's really just a simple looking cigar. You know, simple band, everything looks nice. I'm getting a little sweetness off the wrapper. And the same thing, really, just sweet tobacco off the foot. I'm going to zoom back out a little bit. Seems like I'm not always in the shop. But anyways, let's snip it. I'll lean over here. Very loose draw. Very loose. I'm not really getting anything off the draw, believe it or not. I don't know why, but I'm not. But let's toast it up. I got a feeling this is going to be a full body stick, but I'm not sure. Again, like I said, there's really not a lot of information on the website. And if you go to that arsencigars.com, it's actually saying the site's under construction. So go to the other site that I told you. But I haven't seen a lot of reviews on this stick, so I figure why not, right? All right, we're toasted up. Lots of smoke. Right away now that I got a lip, I'm getting a lot of wood notes. Really strong woody note. Yeah. Woo, really strong woody note. I just got a little bit of something There's something there in the background. It's after the smoke leaves your mouth. I don't know. I can't pinpoint it right now, but we'll get down. Now, it's a little smoke, but I'll still do it in half, so it'll probably be a quick review. So we'll get down to midway. I'll come back. I'll tell you what I think of the Arson cigar, and if I can find a price online, I'll mention that to you. But right now, like I said, there's not a whole hell of a lot of information out there, so stick around, and I'll be right back. All right, everybody, we are back here with our Arson cigar, and I did find some information for you. Price point, depending on the Vitola, is $6 to $7. So if I had to guess, this is smaller or two, you're probably looking at $6. Also, this is a boutique blend, so you will only find this in certain B&M. So if you go over to the sites I told you to, check it out, you'll be able to find it. But if you are on Twitter, follow at Cigar Source, and he'll be able to hook you up. But there's a little more information I was able to find for you. Like I said, there's just not a lot of reviews out there on the cigar. But to the cigar point in question, we're midway, and it's going good. You know, it's I'm getting a lot of woody notes. I'm picking up some leather notes, and a little bit of earthy note. And that note that I think I found, that I told you earlier, I just couldn't pinpoint because it was very mild, and it's still very mild on if you exhale the smoke out of your mouth slowly and then, you know, just move your tongue around in your mouth, is a slight hint of coffee. Very, very small hint of coffee, but it is there. It's got some, it started off very one-dimensional, and now at midway it's getting some complexity to it, which I really like. It's not full. I thought it was going to be full. It's really just a medium body stick, a good, you know, middle of the road medium. Burn needed a little touch up, but nothing drastic. Again, you know, it's a first impression. I haven't tried it before, but you know, my belief, the first one should be as good as the second one, or as good as the fifth one, or as good as the 100th one. You know, it should be, there should be consistency in cigars. That's my belief. But you always get a bum one, but this one's not bum, but lots of smoke. I'll show you. As you can see, it is a dense smoke. I will tell you that the smoke lingers for a while. That's for sure. Even in the man cave, it's lingering around. But it's going pretty good. I'm enjoying it. I mean, definitely $6, man. You know, here in New York, it wouldn't be $6, but you know, you can find them in B&M's, and I know Cigar Source, I believe, is in Kentucky. You can find them in Alabama. There was a few other places I saw online that you can find them. But so far, going good. I'm enjoying the Arson. It's not burning down the house, but it's going pretty good. So we're going to continue on. Nice, short, sweet video. We're going to get down to the final half. I'm going to bring my sorry ass back here, and I'm going to tell you what I got. So don't go anywhere. I'll be right back. All right, my peeps, we are back here in our final half of our Arson cigar. And I'll tell you, I really enjoyed this stick. I did. It changed up in the second half. The wood note is by far the dominant note, hands down. Earthiness, it went away mostly. I still getting that leather, but I'll tell you, in the background, man, I'm getting a nice nut note. Really, really good. Really nice nut note. That coffee note comes and goes every bit, but really digging it, man. Really digging it. Retrohale, it's still, even on the retrohale, you're getting that woody note. The woody note just, it dominates everything. But for a little stick, I was shocked and with the amount of complexity in this little cigar. It was definitely, for $6, hands down, even at $7 for the bigger size. You know, I haven't tried the bigger size, but $7 is still a deal, man. So for the Gordo size, the 4x58, or Gordo, that just made me think of something. I think from now on, I need a name. I need a nickname, and it just hit me. I think from now on, I'll tell you at the end, I'm going to sign off with the new nickname. How's that? But anyways, the Gordito, the 4x58, really good. Lots of smoke. It needed a little bit of touch-up, but nothing to complain about. Medium body, stayed medium body the whole time. But really, really good cigar. I'm definitely impressed. I still got a way to go. I'm still going to smoke down some more. But definitely really good stick. I enjoyed it. But like I said, go online, check them out, find out some more information. I know, like I said, you can get them in Kentucky and Alabama. I want to thank at Cigar Source on Twitter for giving this to me. Thank you very much. I enjoyed it. I hope you guys liked the review. And that's pretty much it. So this is Mike, the great Gordo, 6x60 Williams, signing off. And remember, enjoy your smokes.